Let's get to the Subway Fresh Take Hotline. That's where Jim Mora joins us, the former Falcons coach and former, of course, Seahawks coach, joins us on the Subway Fresh Take Hotline, obviously now works for the NFL Network. And Jim, give me your reaction to how quickly Mike Vick has reascended and now starting quarterback in the league.
Well, I don't think if you ask Mike, it's been real quick. I mean, he sat all last year behind Donovan and learned. He sat out for 2 years in prison for part of that time. But the guy's paid his dues. He's worked very hard to get back where he is. And as well as he's doing on the football field, he's doing better off the football field. And that's what I'm most proud of, is the way that he has restructured his life and become a real positive person in the community again.
I understand all that, and I mean, that's great. Look, Andy Reid and the entire Eagles organization thought Kevin Cobb was the guy. Then 2 weeks in, they changed their mind. They've even said they're surprised at how well he's played. You're not surprised at how well he's played and how quickly he's kind of taken back over at that quarterback spot?
Not really. I mean, the guy played in 3 Pro Bowls in Atlanta, took us to the NFC Championship game. He's always been a good player. So, no, it didn't surprise me. Not at all.
Jim Mora joining us on ESPN Radio. What do you see in terms of his growth in the pocket? What can you point to something?
Yeah, he's more settled. He's more patient. He's less likely to take off and run. I think he understands the game better. It's a natural development of a quarterback in this league that is willing to learn. You're seeing the years and years of education that he's had as a quarterback starting to take place. And he's still a runner, and Andy still wants him to run because that's one of his greatest abilities, is to take off and run, and that's where he scares people when he's on the move as a dual threat. But what he's done a better job of is hanging in there and going through his progressions, sticking with the play a little bit longer before he takes off and run. He's just a more patient, settled player. He's spending a lot more time in the film room than he ever has in his life. I think sitting behind Donovan last year taught him a little bit about what it takes to study and be a complete quarterback, and he's applying those lessons.
Jim Mora joining us. Jim, I got a chance to sit down with former Falcons quarterback, current Eagles quarterback Mike Vick, for an in-depth conversation featured this Sunday on the NFL Network's NFL Game Day morning, 9 a.m. on the East Coast. It's interesting you talk about how he's learned how to watch tape. He's talked about how he's matured, how he's more patient. Does it bum you out at all, though, that he wasn't that bought into what it took to be a great quarterback when you coached him in Atlanta?
No, because he...
I mean, don't you think about what could have been?
Let me ask you something.
Yeah.
Let me ask you something. Do you know anything about this guy's background?
Yeah.
Okay, do you know he went to 3 Super Pro Bowls?
Yeah.
So you're basing that all this on 2.5 weeks of play. You're saying that he wasn't a great player when he was with us in Atlanta?
No, he was. Would you say he was nearly what he could have gotten?
Well, he's not as good then, or he's better now than he was then, but so is every player that plays in the league.
Yeah, but those are guys that play in the league. He was away from the league for 2 years, okay? Then he didn't play, and when he did play, he was strictly a runner. He was brought in as kind of a sideshow. Now,
last year you're talking about?
Yeah, last year was like a sideshow, and all of a sudden he comes back without the reps of 2 years. And, I mean, he's even said he was lazy in Atlanta. I mean, one, it's kind of remarkable how good he was considering he was self-admitted lazy. But I'm just wondering, as a guy who coached him, thought, man, if he would have bought in back then, considering what we had around him, considering the fact that he was playing on a faster surface, how good he had been, you might still be the coach of the Falcons.
I don't live in the past, pal. You might, but I'm looking forward. I'm just happy for Mike.
What do you think the reaction should be for Eagles fans when McNagg comes back in?
I think that however they feel, that's what they should do. If they feel like cheering him, they should cheer. If they feel like booing him, they should boo. Feel? I don't know how people should feel.
Well, you're a head coach twice in the league. I mean, you know how good McNabb has been, don't you think they should feel? They should feel.
How should people feel?
Yeah, how should they feel?
I don't know. I know how I feel. I like Donovan. I hope he does well. How do you think they should feel?
I think that if you boo Donovan McNabb, you're a fool. I really do.
Okay. Well, then don't boo him.
Jim Mora. You can see his interview coming up this Sunday, NFL game morning on the NFL Network. Jim, thanks so much for joining us on ESPN Radio.
Yeah, you are a real joy. Thanks.
Wow. That has never happened before. That's never happened before. I'm not going to take shots. I'm going to take what's called, what's known as the high road.